We want to solve the following quadratic equations by factoring. Notice in the first two examples, we have a trinomial when a is equal to 1. And since there are no common factors here, if this factors, it'll factor into two binomial factors, where the first terms will be the factors of x squared, which are x and x. And now we want the factors of c that add to b, or the factors of positive 4 that also add to positive 4. Well, 4 does happen to be a perfect square, and 2 times 2 does equal 4, and 2 plus 2 also equals 4. So the two factors of 4 that we want are positive 2 and positive 2. So notice that both factors will be x plus 2. So it is true that this is a perfect square trinomial, but we did factor it as we normally do when a is equal to 1. But now since we do have two equal factors, we can write this as the quantity x plus 2 squared equals 0. So this equation will only be 0 when x plus 2 is equal to 0. So if we subtract 2 on both sides, we know our solution is x equals negative 2. Normally when solving a quadratic equation, we do expect two solutions. But since we have two factors of x plus 2, we do only have one solution, but we can say that it has multiplicity of 2, or that it's a double root or double 0. We'll approach the second example in the same way. There are no common factors. If this factors, it'll factor into two binomial factors. The first terms come from the factors of x squared, which are x and x. And now we want the factors of positive 25 that add to negative 10. Again, notice that 25 is a perfect square since 5 times 5 is equal to 25. But since we want a sum of negative 10, it's also true that negative 5 times negative 5 is equal to positive 25, and that negative 5 plus negative 5 is equal to negative 10. So now we're going to have two factors of x minus 5. So again, we have a perfect square trinomial. So we can rewrite this as the quantity x minus 5 squared equals 0. Therefore, this is equal to 0 only when x minus 5 is equal to 0. So if we add 5 to both sides, we have one solution of x equals 5. Again, because there are two factors of x minus 5, we can say the solution has a multiplicity of 2, or that it's a double 0. Now looking at the last example, notice how there are no common factors, but a is not equal to 1. This is when it's helpful to recognize that the first term of this trinomial is a perfect square, and so is the last term. We know this because we can write 4x squared as 2x to the second, and we can write 9 as 3 squared. So my suggestion is when we notice this, let's go ahead and try to factor this as a perfect square trinomial, meaning we'll try to factor this into two binomials. The first terms come from the factors of 4x squared, and we'll use 2x and 2x. The second terms come from the factors of 9, and we'll use 3 and 3. And we'll use the sign of the middle term, so we'll have minus here and minus here. Now to make sure this actually works, we'll check the sum of the inner product and the outer product to make sure we do have negative 12x. Notice how we have negative 6x here and negative 6x here, which would have a sum of negative 12x. So it is a perfect square trinomial, and we factored it correctly. So we can write this as the quantity 2x minus 3 squared equals 0, which means this will equal 0 when 2x minus 3 is equal to 0. So if we add 3 to both sides, divide by 2, our solution is x equals positive 3/2. And again, we can say this has a multiplicity of 2, or that it's a double 0. Notice how in these examples, I didn't apply this formula directly. I'm not a big fan of memorizing formulas, but it is important to recognize that if we do have a perfect square trinomial, the first term and the third term would be perfect squares. And the part that I don't worry too much about is that the middle term would be 2 times a times b, because we checked the sum of the inner and outer product to make sure we did come up with the middle term. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.